technology works as a general solution. So like autonomous driving, like basically across works anywhere.
So it could be sooner for point things, like highway only or...
I mean, highway only, we're already in public beta with a Tesla. So we'll be hopefully in the next several weeks releasing to all of the cars that have the autopilot hardware, which is all cars built in like roughly the last 12 months.
Wow. Wow. And so this seems like one of those things that once you've experienced it, the inevitability of it becomes more apparent. Kind of like first time I sat in an electric vehicle, it's just so clear, and same with autonomous vehicles. Do you think that will help persuade public opinion? And like the regulatory question is an interesting one, because as technology continues to accelerate, human nature doesn't. And acceptance of change, I'm just not sure if there's, like, as we look out in the future, should we assume that no matter how fast something like Moore's Law accelerates, there's always the counterbalancing force of human nature and habit?
There's always going to be the sort of, there's always going to be human nature, and it's sort of difficult to predict, I think, what that will, how that will affect things. I'm not sure if I fully answer your question. So in terms of what I think 2025...
Oh, yeah, please.
So for sure, ubiquitous computing, AI that's beyond anything like the public appreciates today, I think we'll have most of the new vehicles being produced being electric, and we'll be probably have a supermajority of energy being produced being... sustainable. So I think we're on headed
solar primarily in your mind.
Primarily solar, yeah. So I think those are sort of some good things. Like I think we'll be hopefully on a good path for sustainable energy. Sooner is always better, but I think by 2035, I think we'll be substantially most of transport, most of new energy being produced will be sustainable.
Broadband
everywhere. Yeah.
Mars colony,
and hopefully a small base on Mars, or small city on Mars, in 20 years. Yeah,
did I hear?
Well, okay, fine. Town, village, Hamlet.
I mean, that's exciting. I mean, that could get people fired up about the future.
Yeah, I do. I agree exactly. I think that the idea of being multifaceted species and getting out there and exploring the stars is one of those really inspiring, exciting things. I mean, just as Apollo was incredibly inspiring to everyone around the world, and even those, I mean, only a very tiny number of people went there, but I mean, vicariously, we all went there.
Sure.
And I think that's true if we have a Mars base as well. It's very important that we have things that are exciting and inspiring in the future, because otherwise, why get up in the morning? You know, if it's just about one sort of sad problem after another, it's like life's not worth living.